Tonight, an unsettling update from a Father's Day shooting in Aurora. This the scene near 7th and Toledo, where 30-year-old Esteban Lopez was shot while celebrating Father's Day. His brother-in-law, Omar Cisneros, was there that night.
You hear screaming coming from the outside.
He describes the shooting, which happened right across the street from his mother's house. There was a party across the street, and he's not exactly sure what led up to that shooting, as he was inside of his mom's house when it happened.
I just hear, Esteban got shot.
He went across the street to render aid to his brother-in-law. He then calls police as the suspect began shooting again.
He opens his door and he just points his gun at us. And he pauses for a couple seconds and he takes a shot. And it lands, just right next to us, thankfully, and it didn't hit neither of us.
Tonight, police are asking, where is this man? He's 24-year-old Juan Serrano, the suspect in the shooting. SWAT responded to that scene that night where he was arrested for first-degree assault, but ended up bonding out the next day.
First off, a bond is not static, it's fluid.
The problem solver spoke with Fox 31 legal analyst George Brockler, asking why he was even able to get a bond.
Before the victim died, they were only a victim of what law enforcement determined to be first-degree assault. That has a certain bond amount to it, $50,000 sounds about right. But when there's a change of circumstances, including the death of a victim, that likely changes the nature of the charge, makes it more aggravated.
Police tell us updated homicide charges are currently pending against him, but they don't know where he is tonight. Meanwhile, two kids, 3 and 5 years old, are now forced to navigate a new world without a piece of their world in it.
I was there at the hospital when they say their last goodbye to him, and it was heartbreaking.